Hi, I'm Tim Allen. I'm a grad student at the University of the District of Columbia, and I'm in their Masters of Science in Applied Statistics program. I'm going to talk today about median polish. Median polish is an exploratory data analysis technique. It's a technique that can be used to analyze two-way tables. It was invented by a man named John Tukey, and I learned about it from a book called Understanding Robust and Exploratory Data Analysis. Now, I'm going to talk about the step-by-step procedure for doing median polish. I'm not going to talk so much about what median polish is for. You'll find that that book, many web pages, and many other textbooks are very good at explaining what the median polish technique is used for. What I do find that they tend to be a bit weak in for me is understanding exactly the step-by-step procedures for doing median polish. I'm kind of a visual learner, so I found that there was no other YouTube video that did this, so I thought I'd step in and fill the gap. So here goes. We'll talk a little bit about median polish. Now, the idea behind median polish is you're trying to find a way of quantifying a two-way table by saying, and we'll say that the values in each of the cells in the median table are going to be x, I, j. Okay, x sub I, j. All right? Each of those values is going to be quantified by a common value. It's one of the three things we're looking for, basically, for each one of these cell members. Okay? Plus what we'll call a row effect. The row effect, a sub I, is going to be what is added to the common value for a member of each row by virtue of it being in that row. Okay? And then the third value that we're trying to find is the column effect, B sub J. And similarly, the column effect is what is added to the common value, the row effect, by virtue of that member of the two-way table just being in this column. Okay? So here goes. All right, I've laid out a two-way table. I'm going to try to keep this as color-coded as I can. Now, the first thing that you have to do when you get a brand new two-way table and you're going to do median polish is to set the column effect, the row effect, and the common value to zero for this table. This wasn't obvious to me from the text. I had to kind of figure it out. So here goes. You start out, go ahead and put the column effects set to zero. And we can think of these as sort of being accumulators here, where we're going to accumulate each of the column value, column effects, row effects, and common value. Okay, I'm going to set the row effects to zero as well. I'm going to leave a little space here because we're going to need that. Zero, zero, and zero. And then finally, I'll set the common value to zero as well. That's going to be in red here. Okay. All right, the first thing that you're going to do after that is find the median of each one of the rows. Now, I'm going to go row first. It's also possible to do this column first. And they leave that as an exercise within the text. You should get values that are just about the same if you do column first or row first in almost all cases. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and find the median of each one of the rows. Now, one of the things I would say here is slow down. Don't try to rush through this, because there's been many times when I've thought I had the median and I had gone one over to the right or left, and so you don't want to do that. So slow down, and what I do is I just go ahead and count smallest value to largest value and take what's in the middle. Now, this works for a 3x3. When you get larger tables, you may have to think about this a lot harder. And here goes. So negative 15, 1 and 4, I'm going to get 1. And notice I put the parentheses around this. The parentheses are important because you want to keep in mind whether or not you're talking about a row effect or if you're talking about a change in row effect. The change in row effect is always going to have parentheses around them. Okay, 6, 16, 30, that's going to be 16. Okay, negative 12, negative 5, 4, going to be negative 5. Okay, and then down here with the column effects that we've already set up, we want to go ahead and take the median of this as well. Okay, in this case it's 0, 0, 0, so it's going to be 0. All right, So then, after that, we've got the first half of one iteration done. We're not even done with the first iteration just yet. All right. So the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to do what's called a median scrape. That means we're going to take each of these row values and take the row effect out of it. So negative 15 minus 1 is going to be negative 16. 4 minus 1 is going to be 3. 1 minus 1 is 0. Okay. Now, here we go. 6 minus 16, negative 10. 16 minus 16 is 0. 30 minus 16 is 14. Right. Negative 5 minus 5 is 0. Negative, 4 minus negative 5 is going to be 9. Okay, negative 12 minus negative 5 minus plus is going to be negative 7. Okay, so I've gone ahead and done the median scrape. A little frame here. Now, before we get going much further, we'll talk a little bit about what's happened here. These are considered residuals at this point. So residuals are what's left over when you get done explaining what's in the two-way table using the model that you get out of the median polish. I'll talk a little bit more about that in a second here. Okay. So the next operation that you do is you're going to collapse the row effect and the change in row effect here along the side. So I was just saying collapse first. After you've done the median scrape, you're going to collapse. So how do you do that? You add the row effect to the change in row effect. So 1 plus 0 is 1. No parentheses this time. Okay. 16 plus 0 is 16. Negative 5 plus 0, negative 5. Okay. And then down here, we're also going to take the common value and add the change in common value to it. So I'll put that in red. And we want to leave a little bit of space here because we're going to need a row here. Okay? All right. The next thing that we're going to do is we need to set the column effects. Now, this isn't, it doesn't look like much here, but what we'll end up doing is for each one of the column effects, we want to subtract the change in column effect from each one of these values. So we're going to subtract this parentheses value from each one of these values. They're all zeros, so we get 0, leave some room, 0, and 0. Okay. Now the next thing we'll do here to finish off this iteration is to go ahead and put the change in column effects, which we'll figure out by taking the median of each one of these columns. All right, so again, the same operation, negative 16, negative 10, 0, that's negative 10 is the median. Okay, 0, 3, 9 is going to be 3 is the median. Okay, I messed the colors up, all right. Negative 7, 0, and 14 is going to be 0. One thing that's kind of handy here is if you ever have three numbers and there's a negative and a positive and a 0, the median is going to be 0. So that ends up being a little bit quicker. And then finally, negative 5, 1, and 16, I'm going to get 1 as my median. Okay, so we finished our first iteration. All right. Now, one of the questions that you may have is, when do you stop doing this? Because this is an iterative process. You can do as many iterations as you want. In general, I found that 2, maybe 3 or 4 iterations is as many as I've ever needed to use, especially on such a small table. And then what you're really looking for, though, is if you start seeing a lot of zeros over in the change in row effect and change in column effect. When you get the zeros in those change in row effect and change in column effects, then you can pretty well stop. Okay. All right. Let's go on to the next iteration. Okay, so again, we're going to do our median scrape. Let's see if I can pick up the pace here a little bit. We're going to say, negative 16 minus negative 10 is going to be negative 6. Negative 10 minus negative 10 is 0. 0 minus negative 10 is positive 10. Okay, 3 minus 3 is 0. Okay, 0 minus 3 is negative 3. 9 minus 3 is 6. Okay. Here, 0 minus 0 is going to be 0. 14 minus 0 is 14. Negative 7 minus 0 is negative 7. Okay. My first frame up here. Let's see, I get that all right? Yeah, okay. So what's the next thing we're going to do? We have to collapse our column effect and the change in column effect. Or excuse me, we have to collapse our row effect and change in row effect. Sorry about that. So here it goes. So we're going to take negative 10 plus 0 is negative 10. 3 plus 0 is 3. And 0 plus 0 is 0. And then for the common value, the changing common value, 0 plus 1 is 1. All right. Now we'll figure out our new row effects. So it's going to be negative 5 minus 1 is negative 6. 16 minus 1 is 15. Okay, 1 minus 1 is 0. Okay, now let's go ahead and do our median for our change in row effects. So negative 6, 0, and 0 is 0. All right, negative 3, 0, and 14, 0. And then negative 7, 6, and 10, we'll get 6. Okay, and then finally, negative 10, 0, 3, 0. And that's our change in our row effects. Okay, and then finally, we're going to finish off the second iteration. So that's going to be doing our median scrape again. So, and look, these are zeros, so we can just go ahead and say negative 6, 0, 0, 0, negative 3, and 14. And now here we gotta go ahead and subtract these. 10 minus 6 is 4. 6 minus 6 is 0. Negative 7 minus plus 6 is gonna be negative 13. Okay, great. All right. So our next step, of course, is to collapse our column effect to our changing column effect by adding them together. So 0 plus 0, 0. 15 plus 0 is 15. 6 plus negative 6 is 0. And then our common value and our changing common value, 1 plus 0 is 1. Leave a little room here. Okay. And then for our row, our column effects, we'll say 0 minus 0, 0. 3 minus 0 is 3. Negative 10 minus 0, negative 10. Okay. And one last time, we'll go ahead and figure out our column medians. So 6, 0, negative 6, 0, and 4 is going to be 0. Don't forget your parentheses. Okay. 0, negative, or excuse me, negative 3, 0, and 0. And negative 13, 0, 14, 0. All zeros there. And then 0, 0, 15. We get a 0 here as well. Okay, so now we've gotten a whole iteration where our change in row effects is pretty close to zero, except for this one, and our change in column effects were all zero. So, and I went ahead and worked this problem earlier and know that when we do this in the next iteration, we just end up with this same set of residuals again. So what we're looking for when we do this to figure out whether or not we need to stop is if your residuals stay the same from one iteration to the next, you can pretty well stop. And the way that the R program that implements this, medpolish, does it is exactly, well, it actually just looks at the residuals, takes the sum of their absolute values, and if that doesn't change by more than a particular tolerance value, it goes ahead and stops. Like I said, one or two, and that's normally enough. Okay, so what have we gotten out of this? So the first thing, we have our three values. One is the common value, okay? And then we've got our row effects here. These are a sub i's, so this is our row effects. Our row effects a sub I. And then down here, we've got our column effects, b sub j. All right, so we've been able to analyze a two-way table using median polish and figure out our common value, row effects, and column effects. All right, well, hope you enjoyed that. And the one thing I would say about all of this is that it just takes a lot of practice to get this down. Slow down, try to do a lot of 3x3 two-way tables, as many as you possibly can. I'll post something to the YouTube page that will help generate those in an R program, so you'll have a lot of these to work with. All right, thanks a whole lot. I'm Tim Allen at the University of District of Columbia Applied Statistics Program. Thanks.